As you know, this morning between 8 and 8:30, we had a shooting at the Navy Yard. At the time that we last reported to you, we did not have a definite number, and we're still working on a definite number of fatalities, but at this hour, it appears that we have at least 12 fatalities, and we're continuing to try to ascertain how serious this situation is. And it doesn't get much more serious than that, obviously. We have one of the officers for the Metropolitan Police Department is injured. He appears to be, is going to be fine as far as we know. We have no known motive at this stage. There were people who asked earlier if this was a terrorist event. We don't have any reason to think that at this stage, but we're continuing that investigation to try to determine what the motive is. We also don't know for certain whether there are other shooters. There have been reported other people in the building at the time. We're continuing to engage in that investigation, and we'll have better information on that later in the afternoon. We'll be back here at 4 o'clock. We'll be back for another press briefing at 4 o'clock. But now let me ask Chief Lanier if she will come up and provide some more detailed information on some of these issues.
I just want to first start off by saying, and as far as the initial response here this morning, you've heard we have at least one officer with gunshot wounds that is currently being treated, but the response by uniformed police officers from both the Metropolitan Police Department and United States Park Police was absolutely nothing short of heroic. With at least 12 confirmed dead at this point, I think the actions by the police officers, without question, helped to reduce the number of lives lost. So our hearts go out to the families of certainly all the victims here, but our gratitude to the frontline officers of Metropolitan Police Department and also the United States Park Police, who ran into danger this morning to try and reduce the number of victims. I'll start from the top and go through quickly. Right now, we're confirming at least 12 fatalities. We had a few additional folks who were injured. They were not fatally injured. We have additional officers that were injured, only one injured by gunfire at this point, some other injuries sustained by multiple different police agencies on the large response inside. We are officially now transitioning to an FBI lead. So the FBI will lead the investigation. The entire investigation will be processed and handled as a unified process. But with that said, any additional information that anybody might have that they want to share for the investigation, you can call 1-800-CALL-FBI, 1-800-CALL-FBI. I have a slight update on the lookout for potentially two additional individuals involved in the shooting. The first is for a white male between 40 and 50 years of age, white male wearing a tan, what appears to be military uniform consistent with naval uniform and a beret style hat. We also have a lookout for a black male between the ages of 40 and 50 and an olive military style uniform. He is about approximately 5'10", 180 pounds, medium complexion with graying sideburns. We have no indication of any motive at this time. We are updating and asking for family members. We know a lot of folks have cell phones and can contact family members, but if you're looking for contact with any of your family members that may have been inside of the Navy Yard today, NCIS has established a phone number now for reunification. That number is 202-433-6151. A secondary number, 202-433-9713. Right now we have an impact to the area. Obviously a large part of the area is still in lockdown. We're still asking residents to stay out of the area and remain in your home. We do feel like the area is safe, but we do still have an active search for potentially additional suspects right now. So we're asking people to please remain in their homes and stay out of the area. Again, there's multiple agencies here. We've gotten support from a lot of our counterparts in the region, Maryland and Virginia, as well as all the federal agencies here in Washington, D.C. There are very, very few questions that we can answer at this point. still a lot of information to come. We will be doing another update in 2 hours. I think at this point we would take a limited number of questions. We would ask, please, for your patience, and then we'll go from there.
Who should stay home?
We've asked people to stay out of the area around the Navy Yard. We have sent out text alerts to the residents around the area and asked them to please stay out of this area at this time until we send out an additional follow-up.
Why do you believe there were two additional potential shooters? Did they engage the officers, or were they seen, or why? How did this happen?
The question is why do we believe there's two additional suspects? Right now, we have multiple pieces of information that would suggest that we have at least two other individuals that were seen with firearms. We know both of those individuals were wearing military-style uniforms, but did not mean that we do not know if they are actually military employees. But these are people that we believe that are involved in some way, and we're trying to locate those individuals.
What about the shooter who was dead?
What can you tell us about the shooter who was dead?
I can't tell you anything at this point. I can't comment on anything related to anything on evidence or anything on the scene right now. I'll take two more questions.
Description of possible suspects, does that come from eyewitness or video camera footage?
I'm not going to comment on that. We have reason to believe that these people may be involved and we need to talk to them.
Were there victims in more than one building, or did you find victims in different buildings as well?
I'll say this, we are still doing an extensive search. This is a large base. We've got multiple agencies and multiple teams. The remainder of this search could take another couple of hours, so we're not going to comment on the location of any evidence or anything like that, but I'd say in the next 2 hours we do our next update. Our next briefing will be at 200 I Street, for those of you, so we are not here in the middle of the street. We want to clear out this area, so next briefing will be in 2 hours, 200 I Street, and we will try and answer more questions then. If we can, that's all we can say right now. Thank you very much.
Not include the shooter, right? The 12th dead does not include the shooter.
Outside the Navy Yard.
The FBI briefing.
Mayor Gray, the 12th dead does not include the shooter, right?
Yes.